Welcome to How It Works with Holger. We've all been there. We have a web page or a web service, and we are on our development system. And what do? We want to show it to other people. Watching this episode of How It Works with Holger, you will learn how you can share your web page with full HTTPS support and certificates in less than 10 minutes. Of course, we will use a service that is available for free for developers on the internet. But I might also add, this is just one example. There's many, many, many other providers out there that you can research that give you the same kind of capability. So let's look at this example of a TMS web core application that uses WebSockets. And the example is taken from my latest book, TMS Web Core, second edition, How to Build Web Applications with TMS Web Core. And this is an application that I wanted to share with my friends at TMS before I released the book, because this is a great example. But still, as the WebSocket components are rather new, I wanted to share this with them. And I can enter a stock symbol and I can see the trades live. My colleagues at TMS are not going to be able to access localhost port 8000 on this particular machine, right? That is impossible because this is just the web service that is running on my machine right now. And of course, I could deploy this application to a web server that I basically rent and that has a domain associated. I could generate the certificates or purchase a certificate, but that is all too much work for this particular use case because I just want to have somebody a look at this application and give me an assessment if this is a good example. So I actually really want the person looking at my webpage to look at this particular environment. I don't care about that it's like a development server right now. I just want somebody to be able to look at my web page that is running on my developer system. Through mere coincidence, watching a session on WWDC, I saw how a fellow developer published their website on the internet in order to do development with a web service backend that required HTTPS, because if you develop with iPhone or Android, your web services need HTTPS, which is, in my opinion, the second use case where this is very, very useful. If you want to develop on an Android device or iPhone device, you need HTTPS communication, which usually, if you're on a development system, you don't offer. So this tool called ngrok offers you within seconds to deploy or offer your web application, web service. There's also packages available for TCP traffic. So this is really a good solution to get your web page online quickly to share with colleagues. But if you look at the packages that each of these offers entail, there's also something that you can use on a regular basis for project meetings and so on, because there is one downside, of course, that this is a free product. So I already opened my Windows terminal. Yes, ngrok is a command line application. There is no user interface. It's not really required. So what we'll do, we open a command prompt. Windows PowerShell makes this a little bit more cumbersome. And I go into my tools directory and show you here. This is what you get from the ngrok webpage. And then you can talk to ngrok by simply typing ngrok, enter. And there you get all the different commands that you can use. The most important thing is when you want to use this, you download it from that webpage and get different installation possibilities. I just picked download the zip file. And after that, you have to add the token, the personal user token that it identifies you as the user of this tool. And you get this token when you sign up with them. And again, if you look at the pricing page for developers bringing new projects to life, there is a free, no risk option to use. And also all the other options are not particularly expensive. You can see here that you even have TCP traffic that you can serve. And the most important thing that you'll see now if we actually invoke it, let's say I say ngrok HTTP, that's the service that I want to publish, and the application, the web application, runs on localhost port 8000, if I remember correctly. So here, this is 8000. So that is what I type here as the parameter, press enter, and there we go. You see, I have the free plan. That's my name. I was identified because I added the token already. And there is even a web interface available. If I click here and open it, there are no requests to display, so you can even log stuff that comes in on your web page. This is the localhost page. Let me close that. Also, let me close the ngrok pricing page. And you also get information on the console where you are and what is being forwarded. I'm forwarding to localhost port 8000. And this is the URL for the outside world to use. And that is the downside when you use the free package. You basically get random URL each time. So this is really designed for developer meetings, if I'm honest, that you can share a running web application with your colleagues during a meeting or whatever, or a web service that you need have running inside of a virtual machine, for example, and then you have on your computer system another virtual machine that has a client that wants to access this web service. So it's very, very easy to model in a development environment. So let's just left click on this. And it tells me, hey, you're about to visit something. This is basically that people know what they're visiting, because obviously the domain name is not giving that away. So I click visit site and I get the service is unavailable. Of course, I need to add the path. And this is just the configuration of my web core application. If I run this again, we of course need to add the path of the application where it's running. So I add the path, invoke it again, and there is my TMS web core application under this domain name with full HTTPS under a secure connection. And that works just the same for your Xdata web services or other web services that you might have in Delphi to publish them easily with HTTPS enabled so that you can test with a real device, for example, that requires an HTTPS connection. And let me show you that it works. Stock symbol, start. I don't know if it's being traded right now. As you can see, this application really works. If a symbol isn't traded, it's not being shown. Let's see if Microsoft is being traded right now. Yes, Microsoft is being traded. Here is the volume, the price, and you get the live stock data. We can also, I don't think there are any limitations. This is really a real web application forwarding service that is being used. So here we can see the packages as they come in over the WebSocket. If you want this example in detail, go to flixengineering.com/books, and per default, you're being led to this site, and there is TMS Web Core, second edition in English. That's the book this example is taken from. Thank you so much for your interest in How It Works with Holger. Now you know how you can easily publish your web applications, web services that are still in development, share them with other developers, discuss the real application with them online, or also if you share responsibilities in your team, you can this way give easy access to web services that are in development while clients are also being developed at the same time. Take care.